and baked it up. So I hope it's a little more palatable. I think the key is we don't understand enough about the culture. Maybe a little bit of what I just said helps us understand. There's more. We can't just read it in our 21st century eyes and make full sense of it. But it can still speak to us, can't it? Because we can't serve both God and wealth. As Jay read at the very end of it, we're challenged to see wealth for what it is. It is an important part of our life. We need money. We need resources. We need that influence. But part of it is it can become an idol. Money or wealth can become an idol. It's just, which idols are substitutes for God? Wealth can be an idol for those people who have way more than they need and they're gloating and they're hoarding it. Wealth can be an idol for people who don't have very much, wish they had more, and those who scrape by week after week and so forth, like the folks who lined up here yesterday morning. It can be an idol for anybody. So Jesus' words give us a clue and a nudge toward doing what he was warning his own people about. Reach out. Make friends. Each of us is a child of God. And that's one of the lines in our New Testament lesson that Chuck read. Our Savior desires everyone to be saved and to come to a knowledge of the truth. And this is the God we hear from in our Old Testament reading from Amos. The God who chastises and will not forget. I love that last line that you read. God will not forget the deeds of those who trample on the needy and bring the poor to ruin. This is the God who, as our psalm declares, is high above all nations, but lifts up the poor from the ashes. And so today's readings remind us not to make the same mistake that God's people did in Jesus' day. Don't close in on ourselves. We know that any parish, any organization, frankly, can get that temptation at times to get comfortable with ourselves, to overlook persons that are not part of the in crowd. But we live in this fabulous story of God's goodness. And the goodness is for each of us, all of us, in spite of our own shortcomings, in spite of our own wanderings. God reaches out to us all. Yesterday, members of Nativity distributed the gift cards every third Saturday to people in need. This parish gives about $900 a month for that. 35 cars. So a few times we've had to turn people away. We can do more, but we only do what the parish gives. Our parking lot fills up. Go back from last month, and I took that one picture of the parking lot. You never seen it so full of cars. It was that way yesterday, too. I just forgot to take a picture because we were getting ready to go. Thursday, the rector's discretionary fund usually serves 3 or 4 or 5 people. Yesterday, or Thursday, 11. 11 people, mostly needing money for electricity, some of them needing money for food. Yesterday, 5 members of our Nativity Parish drove an hour and a half one way to Resurrection Church in Loudoun, which is just a little this side of Knoxville, to a workshop. The workshop's title was Invite, Welcome, Connect. I think you probably figure out what it's all about. It was full of great ideas, very organized, inspiring, and invite us all to generate ideas. It's a complete package. And in 2 weeks, we have an opportunity here with our Come Home event after the 11 o'clock service, come home, to participate and to think and ask ourselves, who could I invite to this event who hasn't been here for a while? You know, who's been in our parish but got COVIDed out for a while and might just need a little encouragement to return to the life of our parish? And after October 2nd, after that luncheon, what else can we be doing for the people who haven't been here for a while and for our wider community? The potential is just almost limitless. We hear the words of our psalm today, words that stir us up with this good news. God's glory is above the heavens. Give praise, you
us stand and remember our baptism by reciting the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, and in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Prayers of peace. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ Church and the world. Almighty and ever-living God, who in thy holy word has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. We beseech thee also so to rule the hearts of those who bear the authority of government in this and every land, that they may be led to wise decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace. Open, O Lord, the eyes of all people to behold thy gracious hand in all thy works, that rejoicing in thy whole creation, they may honor thee with their substance and be faithful stewards of thy bounty. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor the 9/11 remembrance, Patty and Dale, Brittany and Danny, Marshall and Chris. Are there others? And all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. In our diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for the House of Bishops, for joy in God's creation, and for the mission of the Church. We also give thanks for those happy birthdays this week, Myra Curitan and Don Leisbiker, both on the 21st. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and
and service, and to grant us grace so to follow the good examples of all thy saints, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant these our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen.
Let us humbly confess our sins unto Almighty God. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against thee in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved thee with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in thy will and walk in thy ways to the glory of thy name. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the word of God to all who truly turn to him. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
Peace to you all, and greetings to those worshiping here with us and those worshiping at home. Today starts a four-week series in Sunday school of one of my favorite C.S. Lewis books, The Screwtape Letters. Lee Shell will be leading our discussion, and I'm really looking forward to it. Haven't read it in several years. I'm about 40 pages in, and I remember now why I loved it so much. Also, I am so grateful for a couple of things. One, that we were able to feed 35 families yesterday, but Barbara shared with me, while Father Robert and I, who usually help with that, were out of town, that there were 7 volunteers who helped to come talk to our clients and welcome them and make them feel comfortable. And I thank you guys. I don't know who they are, but I thank you for that. And just a reminder that a couple weeks from now, on the first Sunday in October, welcome home. Come join us for our luncheon, soup with the cool weather now. Hopefully that'll be really good, and grilled cheese. And looking for a couple of guys who might like to flip those sandwiches like they used to do the pancakes with the pancake supper. So let me know if you're interested in cooking. Anything else from you guys? Thank you.
Let us walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Everlasting God, who by water and the Holy Spirit hast made us a new people in Jesus Christ our Lord, to show forth thy glory in all the world. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy,
holy, holy, holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou, of thy tender mercy, didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having remembered his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness to vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and make one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service,